After considerable research, I've finally decided that my next book will be Arlene Francis Says the Darndest Things in the Most Charming Way. Here she is, Arlene.
Does it come in a package rather than lying around loose?
It comes, to use the general term, packaged rather than lying around loose, right?
That would be very general. I might be misleading you if I said yes.
You mean sometimes
either way.
Sometimes it's loose and sometimes it isn't?
Yes, ma'am.
It's true of all of us.
This animal is standing on its hind legs.
Well, if an animal is standing up at all, it would be on its rear end in some...
Well, that would stand on its front legs. Pretty silly.
Miss Stephanie, since you have qualified the context in which we approach this matter, he agrees with you now. Will you continue, Miss Francis?
Oh, that's very nice. Must have very short legs. Is it a monkey that you have nothing to do with?
Now, what do...
And you work for a non-profit making organization?
Yes.
Oh, there are an awful lot of monkeys in that.
Have I got this straight? You don't do much in television, you don't do anything in the movie, and you're not in the theater except for a limited engagement. Must be at the actor's home.
A relationship to the entertainment world?
Uh-huh. Do you appear before audiences?
No.
3 down and 7 to go, Mr. Sir.
Well, who do you entertain?
His wife.
Very difficult making a fortune cookie, you know.
It gets pretty hot, doesn't it?
You have to bend them while they're hot.
That's true of all of us.
Contain any spirits?
Yes,
it does. Uh-huh. Now, when do you look so jolly in your work?
Do you have anything to do with the Income Tax Bureau?
Yes.
Are you an investigator?
Yes.
Are you after me?
The president-elect's son at Georgetown Hospital in Washington.
Who does the baby look like?
Winston Churchill, they all do.
You mean for purposes of
in general use, might it generally be found in one particular room rather than anywhere in the house? In general.
Well, I would stick to one particular area of the house and would not necessarily be found in every room of the house, yes.
Does it have any alcoholic content?
Yes.
And it's not found in every room of the house?
Did I ever buy you a tie?
Yes.
Well, Dorothy must have bought more than one fellow a tie.
It isn't just a mattress, it's a vibrating mattress.
Oh, well, that's the best kind.
Yes, it is.
Is the animal a cow?
Yes.
You have something to do with cows, and your name is not Ferdinand. Do you?
No, don't ask that question. I'm sorry. Why don't we form our own show?
What makes you think you haven't?
But not in real life, like Red Buttons and that darling girl who played
But Red Buttons won.
Now, Leon, so did the girl.
Oh,
the girl.
Sorry. Cancel me out. I'm shaky tonight. Back to your sack. Okay. Sorry.
Miss Palmer, do you wear other than such clothes as you now have on in the performance of your duties?
Sometimes.
Would we recognize more or less what you do if we saw you in your habit?
No.
That's 3 down and 7 to go, Miss French.
Habit?
Habit means a great many things.
Yes, indeed it does, and you be careful.
Ready to go, Miss Francis?
I hope you'll forgive me for asking this, but do you have anything to do with refuse? Things that are... garbage-like?
Yeah.
Ah, you got it.
You have something to do with garbage, as unlikely a thing as I can imagine looking at you. Are you a self-employed garbage collector?
Yeah.
Right. How can anybody refuse her?
Ooh. going to say, Bennett, it would be an absolute waste. But I think we've gone far enough.
Well, I think that, things...
That's translating it right to the litter.
I think things have gone far enough.
Debbie Reynolds was the only lady bullfighter in America.
Oh. What bull did she throw?
He is with the Schaefer Brewing Company, and he's a beer taster, right?
Yes, sir.
We're glad you could make it here tonight, Mr. Gordon.
Thank you, Mr. Gordon.
Well, is the other medium that the public has come to know you, and I presume love you through, radio? You're either a juvenile or a very old man, I know you tell.
Curvaceous young leading lady? I'm afraid not!
Mr. Sir.
Would it be possible that you're masculine?
Yes!
Ms. Francis?
But not for long.
See, Mrs. Conrad operates a lie detector.
Oh.
You do that in people's houses? Do you take the lie detector with you? And
sometimes.
Really?
Sometimes.
For parties.
They do actually.
Mr. Fritcher, I have a very happy memory of a weekend in San Francisco, and I know that it
Pardon me, darling.
My husband, darling.
I thought you were with Mr. McCurtsey there.
If I had been, I would have disqualified myself immediately.
It's a cattle photographer. She does nothing but take photographs of cattle for sales catalogs and presentation purposes, and I thought you were going to get close to it. It's a very tricky one.
Just give her closer than it was.
Catalog.
You're the cow's Richard Avedon.
I don't think there's no imagination in the manhole cover business. Mr. Taylor's company is known as the Silent Night Company. The silent manhole cover.
Holy night if it's a manhole cover.
Oh! Eggs. Do you have something to do with eggs?
Yes.
She doesn't lay them.
Arlene just said she doesn't lay them, that's for sure.
Mr. Palmero, are your services available to both men and women?
Certainly.
Oh, well, I like a man that's as sure as you are. And are your services pleasurable for the people that you serve?
I would think.
Generally, Pedro.
I would be sure that Mr. Palmero would like to feel that they give satisfaction in every case, and certainly in those cases.
He looks like a gentleman that would give satisfaction. Mr. Palmero, your wife just applauded.
Are you married to a gentleman who is also reasonably well known?
No.
That's
not.
3 down, 7 to go, Miss Franklin.
I don't know whether that kind of a no means she isn't married or at all, or she
doesn't think he's well.
Doesn't think he's well.
Well, maybe he is, and she wishes he weren't.
Yeah. Well, I'll straighten out Arlene's question. Are you unmarried?
Yes.
Mr. Sir.
Do you
recently?
Proper answer there. Our guest has an identification with the public so broad in this area that we would have to accept that there is a substantial reputation as an entertainer, although this does not exclude reputations in other fields. Miss Francis.
Well, then you are a singer, dancer, or an entertainer, right? One of those?
Yes.
Are you known for one of those more than another?
Yes.
Well, that kills the singing bit.
I know you're going to dance with Arthur Murray tomorrow night.
You do?
Yes.
I hope I'll dance.
That's what you do with Arthur Murray. I